Just recently, Jess Brownell, who runs Bridgerton, indicated that season 4 would not be available for another 2 years. Why the fuck is everyone making us wait 2 years when shooting begins this summer and the whole thing will be over in a year? During the third and fourth seasons, there may be a spin-off involving Bridgerton, according to rumors. Additionally, are you aware of the most formidable opponent? The Violets Bridgerton. This is the realization of my wildest fantasy. The other two candidates are Lady Danbury and Portia Featherington, but I think you'll agree that Violet would be the better choice for a spin-off series if we discuss it. Some have said that the prequel about Queen Charlotte was the most beneficial development for the Bridgerton world. There are those who rank it higher than the Bridgerton seasons. Given the show's popularity, it's not surprising that Shonda Rhimes and Netflix are already plotting a spin-off. What did we acquire in the 2 years between season 2 and season 3 of Bridgerton? The show's prequel plot centers on Queen Charlotte and Prince George. If we have to wait another 2 years, it may be because there is a prequel set between seasons. Since the Bridgerton dynasty was largely established by Violet's love story with Edmund, she is the most deserving candidate for the spin-off. Her gushing account of her passionate love story with Edmund has been a staple of the show for seasons. To her, Edmund was like breathing air. That was the depth of her affection for him. Edmund is no different. Though our time with him was limited, his affection for Violet shone through even in that little window. Season 3 saw Violet comparing the fiery, public love she had for Edmund to the more subdued, gradual love that existed between Francesca and John. Alternatively, the one between Violet and Edmund was passionate, steamy, and loud. You would love to see it, wouldn't you? We also saw Queen Charlotte's strange family dynamic when Violet was a little girl. Something was off with her mother. Even though he was quite kind to her, her father had an affair with Lady Danbury. Therefore, it would be fascinating to go into Violet's life as a young girl to learn more about her complicated connection with her mother and how she fell in love with Edmund. In addition, a spin-off series following a younger Violet may bring back Queen Charlotte, Lady Danbury, and Charlotte for a reunion. Isn't it just amazing? Shonda Rhimes expressed her preference for a spin-off at a premiere event, saying that she became engrossed in Violet's tale while writing Queen Charlotte. I also believe Netflix is trying to gauge interest in a Violet spin-off based on the number of press stories and social media posts that have brought up this issue recently. Yes, there is, and I'll tell you about Netflix. However, more characters may have their very own spin-offs. Portia Featherington is one of them. I think it would be fascinating to hear her backstory and how she became the person she is now. She obviously didn't wind up in a romantic relationship. We don't know what extent her parents' pressure had a role in her decision to marry Baron Featherington, but her motives were likely to advance her social status. Before she went into the Featherington family, Portia probably had a terrible breakup. She may have been smitten by a guy of lesser status. She was forced to marry Archibald Featherington by her parents, even though she may have loved him deeply. Alternatively, she may have been compelled to locate a new suitor in the Featherington boy, since the man she really loved had abandoned her. The Featheringtons were affluent, but Portia didn't seem to be from a wealthy family either, so it would be fascinating to discover how she arranged for that marriage to take place. Were her plans to get into it a secret? Were other factors at play? For the simple reason that unlike the Bridgerton marriage, theirs was plainly not a happy one. It would be fascinating to learn more about her childhood. Maybe a spin-off including Violet and Portia would be intriguing. That sound good to you? And further spin-off with Lady Danbury. Actually, Agatha before her marriage to Lord Danbury is also conceivable. Some may argue that we are already privy to the resolution of her narrative, as well as Portia's and Violet's, but not every tale needs a happy ending. Therefore, I have no problem as a spectator experiencing heartache. Agatha attempted to flee from Lord Danbury's marriage proposal in season 3 of Bridgerton. What if her motivations were deeper than just evading an unloving elderly man's marriage proposal? What if she had fallen in love with another guy and was genuinely trying to escape with him? Helping his father locate Agatha made Lady Danbury very upset with Marcus. It seemed absurd that this wrath kept her alive for so long. I believe Lady Danbury's wrath sprang from the loss of someone else, which is ironic considering that Marcus was just 10 years old at the time all this transpired. She may have been attempting to escape her father's control and marry Lord Danbury, but she may have had a lover she really wanted to be with. Even if it would be a tragic tale, I'm game. Before this, every program I've listed could serve as a prequel. However, what if the show chooses to spin out certain characters but keeps the same time frame as Bridgerton seasons? As an example, the Featheringtons aren't required to continue appearing on the program, despite my desire for them to, given that Portia has wed off all of her offspring. What if, as a sideshow, we saw Portia's romantic redemption after the marriage of her daughters? Portia deserves to find love after her character journey and growth in Season 3. Season 3 has far too many plot lines, and to be honest, the program could do without a few of supporting characters. Also, I know some people are hoping for a spin-off starring Anthony, but I really doubt that will happen with Jonathan Bailey's meteoric rise to fame and his appearance in Jurassic World. From Shonda Rhimes' vantage point, is there really much more room for their story? Some fans have begun to want a Cantonese program that centers on their time in India. We all know they finish happily ever after. They're married and parents-to-be. And now all fans want is for Kate and Anthony to spend more time together. I get that, but I really doubt it's required. The narrative of Violet and Edmund would make for a more captivating and thrilling viewing experience. Do you have any opinions? When should a spin-off occur? Please share your thoughts in comments below. So guys, before winding up, remember to like, subscribe, and thanks for watching.